Hey everybody, welcome back to Better Computer. My name is Matt, and today we're going to take a look at this key on the keyboard, the Option key. This key unlocks so much on your Mac, and I can't even begin to show you everything, but I will give you a smattering of things today that are useful that you can do with it. Some of these I do every single day. Some of them are fundamental to how I use a Mac, and they change the way I use my computer in some small but significant ways. So let's jump into it first by taking a look at my Mac screen, and it's pretty messy, right? Like, I have all these windows open. They're all kind of overlapping. What if I want to clean it up? I just want to see the app that's in the front. Well, normally Command-H would hide all whatever window you're looking at, but if you want to hide everything behind the window you're looking at, Command-Option-H will hide every app besides the one you're using. The next one is option drag. So if you option drag something in almost any Mac app, if something's draggable, if you hold down the option key, it will duplicate that item. So here's an example in the Apple Calendar. Today I had a reminder to walk Sherman, my dog, at 7:30 in the morning. If I want to do this again tomorrow, just hold down option, click and drag, and there we go. I have another event. I'll move it on to every day this week, and boom, there we go. I didn't have to use any keyboard shortcuts. I didn't have to create the event over and over and over again. Just option, drag, and you'll make a new one in almost every app. Here's a cool one. So if you go ahead and use these buttons up here, the green button makes you go full screen, and then you kind of have to use gestures to move back and forth. That's okay. Maybe you don't want to go full screen, but you do want to have the window maximize itself. Easy, just hold option when you click that, and it will maximize it to the space that's available without going full screen. To undo it, just hold option and click again. Similarly, if we have, let's go ahead and minimize this and pull up Safari where I have multiple windows open. In this case, I can minimize one window at a time by clicking the yellow button, but if I hold option and click the yellow button, all windows from that app will minimize at the same time. Another very small one that is useful sometimes is if you go to your menu bar and you have the Wi-Fi icon here, if you click it normally, you just get a list of available Wi-Fi networks. But if you hold option when you click, then you get all sorts of detailed information about your network. Almost never useful, but on a rare occasion, this is useful and helps you get things that you might need when troubleshooting. This is another niche thing, but it is kind of nice. It's harder than it used to be to get to your system profile information. So if you want to get nitty-gritty details on the specs of your computer, you typically go to the Apple menu, hit About This Mac, hit More Info, and it's going to open up System Preferences or System Settings. Then you scroll all the way to the bottom and do System Report. And then you get this report, which has details on everything on your device. That's not ideal. It's quite a few clicks, and you kind of have to know what to do. If you go to the Apple menu and hold Option, you can go straight to system information. So here's an interesting thing. I've got three Safari windows open here, and if I quit the app and then go ahead and reopen it, it's only going to open with one window, right? And sometimes that's right, but sometimes it's not really what I want. Sometimes maybe I want it to remember those windows. So let's go ahead and pull up some of these. And so now I have three windows open here, and if I hit Command Option Q to quit, that is going to quit and save my windows. So if I open Safari again, those three windows are there. Next up is for when you want to make really incremental changes to the volume or the brightness of your display. So you can go ahead and change the volume just like this with the normal volume keys. But if you want to make smaller adjustments, just hold Option Shift and then hit those buttons, and it'll go ahead and make smaller adjustments than normal. Same thing with the brightness, which I can't demo in this video, but just trust me, it works there as well. Additionally, if you want to quickly get to the sound settings, hold the Option key and hit one of the volume change buttons. It takes you directly to the sound settings in System Preferences. So we all know Control-Alt-Delete on Windows. There is a similar thing on macOS, which is the Force Quit Applications menu. And you get to that by going to Command-Option-Escape. That'll bring up Force Quit Apps, which you can navigate with your keyboard if you need to because your mouse is frozen or something, or you can just select an app and then force it to close. This last one isn't actually using the Option button, but it's really convenient and related to what we've been talking about, and that's the ability to log out of your computer in an instant. So a lot of Apple keyboards, all of Apple's keyboards, have a log out button. A lot of third-party keyboards have that as well, but if your keyboard doesn't and you still want to do that, it's Command-Control-Q. That'll take you out, it'll log you out of your device, and you can just be on your way. So really nice to know that one. Next up, I have two quick ones for the Finder specifically. So you probably know about Command-I to get the info on something you're looking at. Okay, that's 2.9 megabytes. How big is this one? This one is 101 gigabytes. How big is this one? This one is 421 megabytes, right? But there's a better way if you're kind of browsing and quickly looking at the info on different items. So if you select an item and then hit Command Option I, then you get this floating window that will show you whatever you have selected, what the size of it, what the info is on it. So I can see this one's 103. I can just click through these items and see how large each one is. This is very convenient. I use this quite a bit, especially when I'm looking through a folder that's very large and I want to know what I can kill. This is really nice to be able to kind of just click something, arrow through and find what is large, and then kind of dig in to figure out what you can get rid of. Now, once you find that file you want to delete, you can go ahead and drag it to the trash. You can right click and say move to trash. You can also use a keyboard shortcut of Command Delete to move it to the trash for you. Or if you just want to get rid of it immediately, I'm going to undo that, you can go ahead and hit Command Option Delete, which I can't hit because it'll stop my screen recording, but it will just immediately delete that file. So be careful with it, but it will do an immediate deletion, so you don't have to remember to empty the trash. Next up, we have some text manipulation, which is some of my favorite keyboard shortcuts, especially using the Option key. So I have my cursor at the end of the word injecting. What if I wanted to select she said before that? Normally, I would just arrow over and arrow over a bunch. Okay, and then I would hold down shift to select that text. There we go. But what if I told you there was a quicker way to do it? So let me move the cursor back to where I started. If I wanted to move back a couple words, I hold the Option key, and then every time I press the left or right arrow, I'm going to move one word. So I press it a couple times, then I hold Shift, and then go the other direction to highlight the things that I wanted. It makes it easier and more precise to select individual words, and it's just quicker than going one character at a time. You can very quickly arrow through text and find what you're looking for, right? And that's just a lot easier than going one character at a time. You might be wondering, what happens if I hit up or down while holding the Option? Well, easy enough. It'll go to the start or end of the paragraph. So I've got my cursor kind of in the middle of this paragraph. If I hold down Option and hit up, start of the paragraph. Hit it again, it'll do the next paragraph, which is an empty line, then the next one after that. If I go down, kind of what you'd expect, the end of every paragraph from there on out. Really awesome, really convenient. Again, we're focusing on the Option key today, but if you wanted to do the same thing holding the Command key, that goes to the very end of whatever you're in. So if you hit Command up, it'll go to the very top of the document. If you hit Command down, the very bottom of it, and if we kind of move it to the middle of a paragraph right here, hitting Command left, start of the line, right, end of the line. Now, how about typing special characters? Because your keyboard can type a whole bunch of characters that doesn't actually show you printed on the keys. So for example, if you ever wanted to put the Apple logo, that's Option Shift K. Easy enough, right? If you wanted to ever put a cents sign, so if you had something that was like 50 cents and you're like, it would be kind of nice if I could just say 50 cents, no problem. Go ahead and delete that, go to the end of it, and then hold Option and then do the dollar sign, and that's the cent symbol. If you wanted to do euros, this one's going to vary by region, of course, these currency ones. But if I wanted to do euros, that one's actually easy to do. So 50 euros, no problem. Option, and then for whatever reason, the number 3, that'll do the pounds symbol. But okay, I hear you. That's not enough. You want to do something else. How would I type my co-host on Comfort Zone? How would I type her name? It's Neleon, but the E should have an accent on it. How do I type that? Easy enough. To do an accent on a letter, you just hold Option E, and then it's going to show highlighted in yellow, and then you just have to type the letter you want the accent on. So in this case, I would type E again, but I could also do that with other letters, right? You could put an accent on an I. So do Option E, I, there you go. Option E, A, there you go. So you can add an accent just like that. There's a couple other ones for doing different sorts of accents, umlauts, and that sort of thing, just different keyboard shortcuts. I'll try to put those in the description. Ooh, here's a good one. What if you want to do an M dash? You can do like, hello, there. And that's a dash, but it's not technically an M dash, which for the most cases doesn't really matter. But if it matters to you, you can actually write that. Just hold Option dash, and then that's going to do it. You can also do a longer one by holding Shift as well, so Option Shift dash. I'm not 100% sure what the difference is here, but let me know in the comments what the difference is between all three of these dashes. I could probably figure it out, but yeah, no matter what sort of dash you want, you can do it with the keyboard. If you ever need to type a dot, no problem. This is a dot. Just go ahead and hit Option 8. That's cool. And if you ever wanted to say it is 80 degrees outside, no need to write the word degrees, just hold Option Shift 8, and now you have the degrees symbol. Like, seriously, just play around with holding down the Option key while typing a bunch of letters. If I just go across the top of my keyboard right now, going over the numbers, you can see all those. If I hold Shift, that's going to give me even more symbols. So there's quite a bit. This works across basically every letter, every punctuation mark on the keyboard. So play around, you'll find some things. If you need to find something, there's places online you can find all of these listed out somewhere. Next up is a tip for the terminal. So normally in the terminal, you can't use your mouse. I'm clicking around, I can't move my cursor here. I have to use the arrow keys. For what it's worth, you can use that same Option thing we were doing earlier to move one word at a time to speed it up. But if you wanna just click somewhere, you can actually do that. Just hold down the Option key, click where you want the cursor to go, and there it is. Here's a fun one for your browser. This definitely works in Safari, and it kind of works in other browsers, but let's look at Safari for sure. So here's a file that I want to get, and for whatever reason, let's say I try to load it and I get just the plain text of it. Oh, this is annoying, right? Like, I wanted to download this, but for whatever reason, my browser is saying I can't do that. All you have to do, go into the address bar, hold Option and hit Enter, and there you go, it'll download that for you. Additionally, you can download anything. So here's just a link to another website. It's not a thing to actually download normally, but if I wanted to save that HTML, hold Option, click it, it downloads that. So if you're ever in a situation where you have a URL or you have a link that's not downloading how you expect, hold the Option key and click it, and it should download for you. And let's wrap it up with a Chrome tip. So Chrome, if you print, has a custom print interface that does its own thing. But if you don't like that for whatever reason, if you want to use Apple's built-in print system, no problem. Just get out of this. Hit Command Option P to print using macOS's built-in printer interface. So lots of stuff here. And again, this is just scratching the tip of the iceberg. If you ever want to get an idea for what things are possible, let's go to the Finder and go to this menu, and you can see all these things you can do, and they have keyboard shortcuts. If you hold the Option key, you're going to see these menus change, and it's going to show you other things you can do. So there's quite a bit here in macOS. You just kind of have to poke around and find it. Hopefully you found something new in this video. If you did, like a like down below, drop a like down below, and I'll see you here next time. Bye-bye.